Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to make a post process which makes it possible to see an object through a wall. First, click on the character blueprint to open the window. Next, click the Add Component button to create a post process. Create an array by clicking Add Element in Post Process Materials in the Rendering Features section of Post Process. Next, select Choose to set it as an asset reference, thereby you can apply your material as a post process. After saving, exit to the content browser. Next, create a material and click on it to open a window. Set material domain as post process. Now, go back to the character blueprint. Apply the material you just created to the previously made post process array. When you go back to the content browser after you save it, the entire level will be dark. Click material again to open a window. After creating two scene texture nodes, set one as custom depth and the other as scene depth. Next, choose one among a red, green, or blue to set the component mask, then create two component masks. Connect each of them to the two scene texture nodes respectively. Next, hold on keyboard M and click to create a multiply node and connect it to the component mask node connected to custom depth. Next, hold on keyboard 1 and click to create a constant node, set the value to a decimal value, and connect it to the multiply node. Now, connect the multiply node to the emissive color node and you will see that the entire level is white except the remaining dark character. The custom depth node will draw the object with a render custom depth path set on the screen. And you can see the character fades away as it goes far away due to the constant node. Next, after creating a subtract node, connect it to the subtract node like in the video, and then connect it to emissive color. Now, when you go out to the content browser, unlike before, the entire level is white and the character is black. However, when the camera goes behind the wall, the character is not visible. Next, create a 1- node and connect it to the multiply node. If you connect the 1- node to the emissive color and exit to the content browser, this time the character will turn white and all other parts will turn black. Next, create a lerp node by holding down the L on the keyboard and clicking on it, then connect the 1- node to the alpha part of the lerp node. Next, create a multiply node and click while holding down S on the keyboard to create a parameter node, set a name and value, and connect the nodes like the video. After After connecting the LERP node to the emissive color and exiting to the content browser, the character will now be visible when the camera is behind the wall. Next, create one more scene texture node and set the post-process input to 0. Next, create another component mask, check on red, green, and blue, and connect it to the scene texture node. Now, if you connect the component mask to the emissive color and exit to the content browser, you will be returned to the normal screen. After creating the LERP node, connect the previously created LERP node with the component node. Hold down keyboard 3 and click to create a constant 3 vector node and change it to a parameter. Change the constant 3 vector node to the color you want and connect it to the LERP node. If you save the material and go to the content browser, you can see that the entire level is discolored with an awkward color. But now, if you move the camera behind the wall, the character can be seen through the wall. To prevent discoloration, create two clamp nodes and connect them to the subtract node and multiply node as shown in the video. Now, save and look at the level. You will see the character over the wall with the color you choose. To apply this to objects, copy any mesh in the level and place it behind the wall. Then, find and check the Render Custom Depth Pass item in the detail of the copied mesh, and you will be able to see objects through the wall just like the character.